Welcome back to No Fear Equity. In the last episode, we discussed the ins and outs of raising funds for your startup via safes and convertible notes. In this episode, we'll dive a little bit deeper and discuss some of the key terms and phrases that you need to know when raising a safe or a note. Let's get into it. Okay, so last lesson we went over a few things. We discussed what safes and convertible notes are, how they differ from priced rounds, and some of the high-level pros and cons of each. Now, let's get our hands dirty and learn some vocab. Here are the key terms you need to understand if you're planning to fundraise on a safe or convertible note. One of the key components of safes and convertible notes is the valuation cap. This is a number that you set with your investors that defines the maximum price at which you'll convert their investment into equity, which sounds really fancy, but what does it really mean in English? Let's break it down. You're raising your seed round. Your investor is a nice lady. Her name is Mary. Mary gives you $1 million on a safe note. But remember, when you raise on a safe, you're not actually giving Mary any shares yet. You're going to give her shares in the future, but not today, meaning right now, you don't need to set any kind of share price. Now, it's important to remember, setting a share price is a big deal because when you do that, you're placing a value on your company. For example, if you have 100 shares and the price per share is a dollar, then guess what? Your company is valued at $100. This is what a valuation is. So back to Mary. Since she's giving you money on a safe, you're not bringing shares into the picture yet, which means you're not setting a valuation for your company. This is pretty risky for Mary. After all, she's giving you $1 million without yet knowing the current value of her investment. So in order to protect Mary, you need to provide her with a valuation cap. You set this valuation cap at $5 million. All right, cut to a year later, you're now at your Series A and you have a new investor named William. This time it's a priced round, meaning William gives you money and for that money you give him shares. This means you now have a share price, which means you've officially set a valuation for your company. You and William decide that your whole company is worth $10 million and each share is worth $1. This means in total, your company has 10 million shares and the price for each share is a dollar. For his investment, William gives you the same thing Mary did, $1 million, and in exchange, you give him 1 million shares, amounting to a 10% stake in your company. Just to recap, the valuation is $10 million, and the share price is $1. Great, so it's now time to convert Mary's investment from a year ago into shares. This is where the valuation cap comes in. Remember, William valued your company at $10 million, but because Mary set a valuation cap of $5 million, you're actually gonna give Mary her shares as if the company is valued at $5 million today. So what does that actually mean? You gave William 1 million shares, right? And Mary invested the same amount of money that he did. So how many shares are you supposed to give to Mary? Luckily, the math to figure this out is pretty simple. First, you just need to figure out Mary's share price. To do this, just take the valuation cap that you set with her and divide it by the official valuation that you set with William in the Series A. This gives you Mary's share price. And notice, while William's paying $1 a share, Mary will actually receive her shares at 50 cents per share. Now, Mary invested $1 million at 50 cents per share, meaning when you convert her safe investment, you'll give her 2 million shares or a 20% stake in your company. Now, right away, you can see how the valuation cap is an incentive for Mary to come in early and take on that extra risk. She and William both invested the same amount, but since Mary came in earlier, she actually got twice the number of shares that William did. This is why the valuation cap is an important incentive to get early stage investors on board. And the valuation cap isn't the only incentive out there. For key term number two, let's talk about the conversion discount. The conversion discount is exactly what it sounds like. You're raising a convertible note and you say to the investor, hey, give me some money today. And in the future, when I raise my Series A, I'll give you a little discount on the share price. Let's see an example. Mary's investing $1 million in your seed round on a convertible note with a 20% conversion discount. A year later, same situation, William invests in your Series A and he gives you a chunk of money in exchange for shares. He agrees to pay $1 per share. Great, so it's now time to convert Mary's investment into shares. And because you set a 20% conversion discount, Mary now receives her equity at 80 cents per share. Easy enough, right? But here's the catch. What if you work out a deal where the investor wants both a valuation cap and a conversion discount? Does the investor get to take advantage of both at the same time? Not necessarily. Typically, there's a provision in the contract that says you'll use whichever one benefits the investor the most, i.e. whichever one gives them the most shares for their money. Okay, so that was a simple example, but it's rare that you're you're just talking to one investor for each round, right? What if you're talking to multiple investors for your seed round and they're all negotiating different terms? This is where you might start to see a thing called a most favored nation clause. Basically, it says that if Mary invests in your seed round today, but tomorrow some other guy invests in your seed round with better terms, like a lower valuation cap or a better conversion discount, then Mary gets to change her contract to match the terms you gave to that other guy. All right, so now that we've learned some vocab, in the next lesson, we'll dive a little deeper and discuss a major point of confusion for early stage founders, the difference between a pre-money safe and a post-money safe. Thanks for watching No Fear Equity. We hope you found it helpful, and we'll see you on the next one.